Okay, let's take a look at this Maclaurin series question from the 2023 A-level for the math paper. First one, we are going to find the Maclaurin series for e to the x. It's just the Taylor series for e to the x centered at 0. It's just the power series of e to the x centered at 0. They are all the same thing. So you just have to write that down. The expanded version though. So here we have e to the x. This equals 1 plus x plus x squared over 2 factorial plus x to the third power over 3 factorial. And that's it, because they just want us to write up to the x to a third power term. So this will do it. And you get one mark for writing this down, which is not a bad deal, because the next one is much harder. We are going to find the Maclaurin series for e to the x minus 1. And I actually tried this a few times. I think this right here is the easiest way to do it, at least for me, right? So let's have a look. So first, to get e to the x minus 1, you have a few ways to look at this. You can first plug in this into all the x's here, and then expand it. And then whenever you have e to the x or whatever, you use this again, because we are going to end up with a Maclaurin series. Remember, it's a power series, meaning you don't want e to the x anymore. You will have to have x to some whole number power at the end. But I think that took a while for me, so this is how I'm going to do it. I'm actually just going to use this, plug into this e to the x first. So I'm looking at this as e, and then this e is now all that, which is 1 plus x plus x squared over 2 factorial is 2, plus 3 factorial right here is 6. So like this, and then I will just put on plus da da da. And then at the very end here, we have the minus 1. And now, the small beauty is that this and that will cancel. So it really depends on how you want to approach this. This is okay, or if you want to put this into here, 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 and then so on, that's fine too. I think this is just a little bit easier. All right, now next, we are looking at this as, let me just write it down here because I need a lot of space. This is just e to the power of x plus x squared over 2 plus x to a third power over 6, and technically plus da da da, so on. But we just care about these three terms because that's how the question wants us to have. Now, I checked out the official solution. They use the rule of exponent. They broke it down into e to the x times e to the x squared over 2 times e to the x to the third power over 6, so on. And then they plug in the power series and all that. Again, that is an okay approach as well. It's going to take a while either way, right? Whichever way that you are going to do it. What I'm going to do is, I'm going to just look at this whole thing, right? Especially these three terms. I will plug in this into here, here, and here. So my first term is this one, and then come up next, it's all this. So I'll put on plus x squared over 2 plus x to the third power over 6. And then technically I just put on plus dot dot dot. And then continue plus 1/2, let me write it in the front, and then x squared. So it's all this as the input and then square. X plus. Don't worry, we don't have to multiply all that. You just have to multiply what we need. I will show you. Plus dot dot dot. Square, and then 1 over 3 factorial, which is 6. And then same thing, x plus x squared over 2 plus x to the third power over 6 plus dot dot dot. And this is to the third power. And then technically plus dot dot dot. All right? But anyways. Okay, so we just want to end up with x to the third power term. So we need this, this, and all that. So this right here, 1 plus x squared over 2 plus x cubed over 6. We need all that plus dot dot dot. Now, here's the annoying part of, because this thing is to the second power. So I will show you what we need. I'm going to write it down twice right here real quick. So this is x plus x squared over 2 plus x cubed over 6 plus dot dot dot, and then times x. plus x squared over 2 plus x to the third power over 6 plus dot dot dot. All right, we're going to take the x times x. That gives us x squared, so we need that. So right here, I still have the 1 half all the way in the front here. And then that will have x squared first. And then next, we take the x times that. That will give us x to the third power, so we need that. Plus x to the third power over 2. So already is just that. And then if we take this times that, that gives us x to the fourth power. We don't want that. So I just put on plus dot dot dot. And then continue with the next term. Take this, multiply with that. That will give us, oops, that should have been x to the third power. This times this, x to the third power. This times this, another x to the third power. So we need that, and over 2. But if you take this times that, we get x to the fourth power, so we don't need that. And then similarly, for the rest, if you have x to the third power times x, whatever, you know, it's higher than x to the third power, so we don't need any of them. So, dot, dot, dot. That's all. That's all the expansion that we need. And then, for the last one right here, notice we have the x, and then raised to the third power. This is the only part that will give you x to the third power. Whatever you do later on, you are going to get higher power than x to the third power. So all we care about is plus 1 over 6 times really just x to the third power. And then plus dot dot dot. And after that plus dot 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 from here, right? So we have 1 plus x squared over 2 plus x to the third power over 6 plus dot 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 plus distribute the 1 half, it should have been plus, and then plus 1 half x squared, and then depends on how you want to write it. You can combine like terms right here already, but doesn't matter. Plus, I'm just going to distribute as how it is over 4, and then plus dot 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 plus x to the third power over 4 plus dot 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 plus this times this is 1 over 6 x to the third power plus dot 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 all the way dot dot dot. And finally, you just have to combine terms. So 1 is 1, x is x, very nice. Now, we need the x squared term, right? So half and half. So that will give us just 1, so it's plus x squared. And then for the x to the third power term, let's look at the blue part. We have 1 over 6 plus 1 over 4 plus 1 over 4 plus 1 over 6. So just real quick, 1 over 6 plus 1 over 4 plus 1 over 4 plus 1 over 6. So that's 1 half. This is 1 third. Depends on how you want to add the fractions, doesn't matter. And then plus 1 half. So that's 5 over 6. So plus 5 over 6 x to the third power. And then you know it. Plus dot dot dot. And that will do it. Yeah. I think this is really, seriously, the shortest approach. I'm going to claim that. At least it fits everything on my board, right? You can try the other approach. Yeah, anyways.